Topic is UV visible spectroscopy. We can learn the basic concept and theory of UV visible spectroscopy. Relative energy of orbital involved in the UV visible spectroscopy. Transitions of outermost electron in the molecule. Beer-Lambert's law. Deviations from Beer's law. Single component analysis methods. Ultraviolet or UV spectroscopy and visual spectroscopy are most widely used techniques for pharmaceutical analysis. The wavelength of UV region is smaller than wavelength of visual region. UV region is classified in near UV, extreme UV and far UV region. The near UV region is closest to visible light, extreme UV region is closest to X-ray, and far UV region lies between the extreme UV and near UV. Vacuum UV region includes both far UV and extreme UV region. In this region, vacuum apparatus is often used because the light is strongly absorbed in air. Absorption of UV visible rays causes transition of valence electron in the molecule from highest occupied molecular orbital, HOMO, to lowest unoccupied molecular orbital, LUMO. This technique is also known as electronic spectroscopy. Here, in schematic diagram, when UV or visible radiation get absorbed, the valence electron moves from ground state energy level E1 to excited state energy level E2. The relationship between energy absorbed E2 minus E1 or delta E and frequency nu, wavelength lambda is related. E2 minus E1 equal to delta E and that is equal to H nu. And when we simplify it, it is Hc upon lambda. Here H is Planck constant and C is velocity of light. The energy difference between ground state and excited state are unique for each species. Hence, this provides a means of characterizing the constituent of the sample of matter. Relative energy of orbital involved in UV visible spectroscopy is given in schematic diagram. There are three bonding orbitals, sigma, pi and n, and two antibonding orbitals, pi star and sigma star. Electrons get excited from bonding orbital after getting UV energy and jump to higher energy level, that is antibonding orbital. Sigma to sigma star, pi to pi star and n to pi star transitions may occur. The energy of sigma to sigma star is highest as energy gap is more and energy of n to pi star is least as energy level gap is less. Transition consists of the excitation of an electron from molecular orbital, usually non-bonding n, bonding sigma or pi orbital to next higher energy orbital, that is an antibonding sigma star or pi star orbital. The part of molecule is responsible for transition is called chromophore. Sigma to sigma star transition belongs to saturated compounds, where promotion of an electron from low energy lying sigma orbital to high energy sigma star antibonding orbital. Example, alkene. Sigma bonds are strong, therefore transition require higher energy or higher frequency or lower wavelength of UV region. that is nearly equal to 150 nanometer. Therefore, such transitions are studied in vacuum UV region. Pi to pi star transition belongs to unsaturated compounds, for example alkene, aromatics, etc. In simple alkene, several transitions may occur, but lowest energy transition is most important, that is pi to pi star transition or K band at 172, 190 nanometer. For example, lambda max of ethylene is 171 nanometer. Other transition is N to pi star transition that belongs to unsaturated compound with one hetero atom and unshared electron pair. In this transition, unshared electron pair is excited to pi star antibonding orbital. In saturated aliphatic ketone, the lowest energy transition involve N to pi star transition or R band. For example, lambda max of acetone is 217 nanometer. In conjugated system, one single bond is present between two double bonds. The arrangement is single bond, double bond, etc. Electrons are delocalized and lower energy required to excite these electrons. In conjugated diene, the pi orbital of separate alkene group combine to form new orbitals. Two bonding orbital named pi 1 and pi 2. Two antibonding orbital named pi 3 star and pi 4 star. The transition between the new orbital pi 2 to pi 3 star is now possible as a result of conjugation and requires very less energy than pi to pi star transition. Therefore, energy is less, frequency is less, and wavelength is more. A common feature of colored compound is a system of extensively conjugated pi electron. The lambda max of 1,3-butadiene is 217 nanometer. Beer's law states that absorbance is directly proportional to concentration of solute at fixed path length and fixed wavelength. Lambert's law states that absorbance is directly proportional to the path length at fixed concentration of solute and fixed wavelength. When Beer's law and Lambert's law combine together, Beer-Lambert's law states that absorbance is directly proportional to the product of concentration and path length. Capital A equal to small a, small b, small c, where capital A is measured absorbance. Small a is absorptivity coefficient. Small b is path length. And small c is analyte. When concentration units is in molarity, the Beer-Lambert's law is written as capital A equal to epsilon BC, where epsilon is wavelength dependent molar absorptivity coefficient. As per Beer's law, absorbance should be directly proportional to the concentration. The plot between absorbance and concentration, a straight line should be obtained. However, this is not always true and there are certain limitations. The upward curvature, curve A, is known as positive deviation and downward curvature, curve C, is known as negative deviation. Three types of the deviations are observed: real deviation, instrumental deviation, and chemical deviation. Real deviation or true deviation occur due to following factors. Beer's law is applicable only for dilute solution, but when solution is concentrated, the absorbing tendency get affected and shadow effect may also observed. when refractive index of the sample is changed. Other cause is each molecule does not absorb in same manner. Less absorbing species in presence of high concentration of electrolyte. Environmental factors such as temperature, pressure and solvent. Instrumental deviation involved, stray radiation, non-monochromaticity of radiation, fluctuation of radiation source, defect in detector amplification system, broad band or wide slit width, mismatched cuvette, electronics and reliability of optical parts. Chemical deviation are due to ionization, dissociation, hydrolysis, reaction with solvent, effect of pH, complexing agent and polymerization. Single point analysis methods. First method use standard absorptivity value. With the help of reported value of A1% 1 cm and corresponding absorbance, the concentration of unknown solution can be determined by following formula: A equal to A1% 1 cm multiplied by concentration. Second method involve calibration graph. In this procedure, different dilution of standard solutions are prepared and corresponding absorbances are determined. The calibration curve is prepared between concentration and corresponding absorbances. The concentration of unknown solution can be determined putting the value of absorbance of unknown sample. In third method, single point standardization method, absorbances of standard and samples were determined and concentrations of standard solution put in the formula, and by that we can determine the concentration of unknown sample. In double point standardization method, absorbance of standard solution at two different concentrations are determined. At the same time, absorbance of S sample is also determined. With the help of formula for double point standardization, we can calculate the concentration of test sample.